Mark Twain really is one of the most incredible and influential writers in American literature, and his influence is still very much palpable in writing today.
Called by many the father of American literature, Mark Twain was born Samuel Langhorne Clemens on November 30th, 1835, in Missouri.
When Samuel was 12, his father died of pneumonia. At the age of 15, he got a job working for his brother Orion's newspaper, the Hannibal Western Union.
Mark Twain became a cub pilot on a steamboat on the Mississippi River. He later became a full-fledged pilot, and he thought it was the best time of his life. But in 1861, when the Civil War broke out, the steamboat trade absolutely came to an end, and he was out of a job.
Twain very briefly served in the Confederate military. That did not work out, so he then headed west with his brother. He eventually made his way to San Francisco and really began his career again as a journalist.
Twain's first big literary break came in 1865 with the publication of Jim Smiley and His Jumping Frog.
It was a huge success and was printed and reprinted all over the country. His first bestseller was Innocents Abroad, which was published in 1869, and is still very much one of the most successful and widely renowned travel narratives of American literature.
Mark Twain's best-known and best-loved books, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer, published in 1876, and Huckleberry Finn, published in 1885, are probably the reason that Ernest Hemingway famously said in 1935 that all American literature comes from Mark Twain.
Huck Finn shows the possibility of making genuine moral changes in a world that's dominated by racism and other forms of human folly. It also was a book that was able to capture the vernacular speech of different classes along the Mississippi, and Twain was the first person to put this kind of vocabulary into American writing.
Twain was an immensely prolific writer. He wrote 28 books, a vast number of stories, lectures, essays.
In his last 15 years, Mark Twain was probably the most celebrated American around the world. He received honorary degrees from Yale and from Oxford. And in 1895 and 96, in order to pay off debts, he did a lecture tour around the world, which drew huge crowds.
Mark Twain is now thought of as America's first celebrity because he was so good at capturing the public imagination, and it became important to him to have a public image. He always went on book tour wearing a white suit, and he only wanted to be photographed in that white suit. He tended that image very carefully.
At the age of 74, Mark Twain died at his Connecticut home on April 21st, 1910.
I think Mark Twain is one of these towering figures in American literature because he is funny and smart and willing to sort of shoot arrows at the most powerful. And I think that there's something deeply in the American character that responds to that.